What's going on YouTube? Josh here checking in. I wanted to talk a little bit about my previous training cycle and basically go through some of the footage from the mock meet I posted about a week and a half ago. So coming into this mock meet, I had just finished taking a final exam in school. If you're new to the channel, I'm a medical student. So, you know, I was studying quite a bit, didn't get the best sleep, and I was honestly really looking forward to crushing some serious weight, and I ended up taking some pre-workout. I don't normally take pre-workout, but honestly, it really helped me keep my energy levels up and my focus, and I think I'll probably continue to do that for mock meets and powerlifting meets going forward. So coming into this for squat, I was honestly pretty concerned because throughout this entire training cycle that was 8 weeks long, I was dealing with a nagging injury in my left tensor fascia latae muscle where it would basically cramp up every time I would squat, and since that muscle is right near the hip flexor, it really would throw off my biomechanics in the movement. As a result of that, I honestly got maybe one out of every three squat workouts was a decent squat workout. So because of that, I was really not sure where I'd end up. So let's go right to the footage. I opened up with 385, which was a weight that I've tripled before. Felt pretty good. My biomechanics felt good. The bar path was good. No complaints, but you know, openers, you can't really tell where you're at. I think second attempts is really a much better place to determine where you're at. So 405, I've done this maybe, you know, four or five times in ever. So this was my second attempt, and the speed was decent, and you can't really tell from the front view, but basically my butt sort of went back on the ascent, and as a result of that, it kind of threw off my normal biomechanics of the lift and the normal way that I perform the squat. So it felt kind of harder than it should have, had to strain a little bit more than I would have liked. So basically coming into this, my next choice was, what am I going to do for my third attempt? And honestly, I really wanted 425. 415 was my previous PR, but that 405 was kind of like questionable. Didn't really feel perfect. And I knew if I was going to get 425, I needed to be in the zone. So basically, the guys who were in the gym at the time, they said it looked pretty good. I really wanted 425. I wasn't really going to be happy with 420 or hitting 415 again. So I decided to go for it. And preceding this lift, I was really getting mentally focused, visualizing the lift, you know, kind of getting in that place, wherever that is for me is different than for you, but, you know, getting into that, the zone, so to speak. So loaded 425, got amped to the point where when I unracked it, it felt lighter than the 385. So, you know, there's definitely a lot to be said for the mental game for lifting, especially maximal lifts. And, you know, there was a struggle, but compared to my 415, the previous training cycle, this actually looked easier, which is pretty ironic considering all the trouble I had with my squat this training cycle. And shout out to George for that spot. So onto the bench press. Previous training cycle, I hit a 250 bench. And my strength was probably a lot higher than that, but I just didn't peak properly. I had to essentially deload my bench longer than expected. So for this training cycle, the last heavy bench I did was about 4 to 5 days prior to this meet. And that was a perfect amount of time for me to recover, but also still have my nervous system used to handling heavier loads. So I opened with 250. It went way better than the previous training cycle. So that was awesome. Next, I went up to 260. And honestly, that's all I wanted out of this training cycle. That was my goal, 260. But I wasn't sure if my butt came off the bench. And as a result of that, I decided to go for 265. I took my shorts off, so I was only wearing the compression shorts, and I had somebody look at my butt to essentially make sure it was a good lift, because, you know, there's no sense in cheating yourself and saying you got a lift when it was really no good, especially since I'm planning on competing. So let's talk a little bit about deadlift. Basically, I had made a few rep PRs going into this. 3 or 4 weeks or so prior to this, I like to make rep PRs in my training prior to doing mock meets or meets. And I was making about 20 or so pounds on my rep PRs. So I figured I'd probably be good for maybe 25 pounds onto my deadlift. My previous deadlift was 525 as a sumo pull, and that was a struggle. So my 495 went up pretty good. This 525 honestly felt amazing, and I think as far as sumo form goes, I think it's pretty spot on. And considering that was my old one rep max, I was honestly surprised myself. Why do I think I improved so much in my sumo deadlift? It's really hard to say. This is the first training cycle that I've actually deadlifted twice per week. So initially I was deadlifting sumo one day, conventional the other day. And then as I got closer to the mock meet, I basically pulled sumo twice per week and I stopped pulling conventional. So it could have been the increased frequency. I think a lot of it also had to do with the fact that I was just really amped up to lift heavy fucking weights today. Sometimes you're just in that zone, and I definitely harnessed all of that energy and got everything out of me, which is great. So basically that 525, like I said, went awesome. From there, the original plan was to go for 550, but because that 525 felt so damn good, I just said, fuck it, I'm going 565. So this is 15 pounds over what I had planned on doing, and this was a 40 pound PR on my sumo deadlift. And an all-time PR for any deadlift, because my conventional PR is 535. So this was really epic. As far as the form goes on this, there was definitely a bit of form breakdown. You'll see that on the ascent of this lift, basically sort of one hip rises earlier than the other, kind of bar goes to the side a little bit, but I finish it out, no problem. That was the first time actually that I ever had a challenge locking out the lift. I mean, it doesn't really look that way. The bar didn't slow down tremendously, but it felt challenging for me, and I could feel that my grip was actually almost starting to come loose. So going forward in the upcoming training cycle, I'm probably going to incorporate some reverse band and maybe some block pulls for my sumo, basically as a means of preventing any issues with lockout going forward, just because I don't think I've ever handled weights like that where I would come into those issues. So going forward, I'm probably going to do pretty similar thing with my programming, doing a linear periodization 4 days per week, upper lower split. That's basically the gist of it. It's going to be interesting how I'm going to manage this with school, because I'm currently preparing for the boards for medical school, and as a result I have to study a tremendous amount, so I might have to cut down on the volume and I might have to rearrange some things, but I'm gonna, you know, kind of take it week by week, day by day, and see where it takes me. Honestly, if I can replicate these results, and even if I can get 20 or 30 pounds onto my total in an 8 or 12 week cycle, that's awesome. That puts me in a good spot. So right now my total is 1255. If I want to qualify for RUM 8, I need 1344, assuming that I'm able to make the cut to 165. So I've got a way to go. I'm going to keep on trucking, keep at it, and that's basically it. If you guys have any questions, please feel free to comment below. If you are not a subscriber, please subscribe. And if you like the video, like the video. I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.